into oversexed video vixen. But through her ever-morphing image, Christina Aguilera undeniably laid claim to one title, one of the greatest vocal talents of her generation. Now, 4 years removed from her stripped era, the noticeably more mature, grounded, and newly married Christina has traded in the lascivious leather of ex-Tina for the vintage Hollywood glamour of Baby Jane, her new screen siren alter ego. With platinum curls and red, red lips, she's going back to basics. The name of her new double disc CD that pays homage to the classic jazz and blues she grew up listening to. In order to capture that throwback vibe, Aguilera called on veteran hip-hop producer DJ Premier and previous collaborator Linda Perry, who co-wrote this Christina classic.
She gets you to that gut-wrenching place that's so stripped away and so vulnerable that sometimes it makes you feel, like, where are my clothes?
I've got trouble, 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 always knocking at my door.
Was there, like, one particular moment when you said, you know what, I want to do this kind of throwback-oriented record?
I kind of always, you know, old blues and soul and jazz music has always been my favorite kind of music. Even when I was, you know, yay high, 7 or 8 years old, I used to call it my fun songs to sing. You know, the old soul singers that you could only find, like, on vinyl back in the day. I just was so drawn to that.
Were you, like, the only kid on your block who listened to that kind of stuff?
I was weird, yeah. I was different. Blues is derived from pain, and at a, you know, very young age, you know, kind of with my childhood growing up and whatnot, I just gravitated toward it. And I knew eventually I wanted to make a very, you know, soulful record, but maybe with a modern day twist, and I kind of wanted to incorporate the whole look and feel and vibe and sound, and that's where Back to Basics and this next, you know, chapter of my life is revolved.
Do you consider it a challenge to seeing if your younger fans will get the sort of throwback orientation of the record?
It's interesting. I had that realization kind of when I had my TRL visit for the first time in a while, and I was like, oh, what if they don't get it? You know, like, you don't think about that. What an amazing welcome back. Thank you. Just when I talk about it, I think they get how inspired I am and how passionate I am about what I'm doing. And, you know, I was a teenager when I first came out on the scene, huge pop explosion part of that whole thing. And I think, you know, music has changed since that time that I came out. You know, it has grown up a bit. And I think the fans have grown up a bit, too. And I think they know by now that with each record that I kind of like to go to a new place.
Well, I think challenging as a choice for a first single is Ain't No Other Man, because as a hot record as it is, it's not a conventional single. It's song structure and those
right.
The horns.
But I'm also the kind of artist, I don't go to, when I go to make a record, I'm like, okay, who's hot now? Like, let me go to that producer, this hit maker of the moment. You know,
right.
I'm so not into that. I think that part of how I feel I need to express myself is always kind of going left field or thinking in a new direction and trying to challenge myself. The people that I chose to work with, especially, you know, Premier, DJ Premier has never, ever entered the quote-unquote pop scene or
right.
world. And I am a, you know, a hip-hop fan, and I am familiar with his music and a lot of the stuff he used to do with Biggie Smalls and Gangstar, and he did a lot of jazz elements. He chops things up. He goes for the obscure records and pieces and sounds. And we were able to keep those old elements, thrown with a modernized beat. I thought the melody kind of sounded almost as if you would take one of my old favorite soul singers and have them sing a melody of today in that kind of
mm-hmm.
vein is, was
mm-hmm.
what I wanted to accomplish. And it's fun.
Don't you feel like you've come a hell of a long way in just a few years?
Yeah, I mean, I feel from the place that I was at, to be able to, you know, be such a hands-on artist now, I'm just, you know, it feels amazing. I've done a lot of growing and a lot of healing since my last record, and I'm finally in a place that, you know, I feel pretty at peace. I'm happier than I've ever been, really. A lot of
you
good
feel
things.
Like, I mean, obviously finding oneself is probably an ongoing project.
Absolutely.
You know,
yeah, and I'm not done.
Exactly.
My sister and my friends, hold the other, my lover, no past and present, all right. And every time I see
gut-wrenching place that's so stripped away and so vulnerable that sometimes it makes you feel, like, where are my clothes?
I've got trouble, 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 always knocking at my door.
Was there, like, one particular moment when you said, you know what, I want to do this kind of throwback-oriented record?
I kind of always, you know, old blues and soul and jazz music has always been my favorite kind of music. Even when I was, you know, yay high, 7 or 8 years old, I used to call it my fun songs to sing. You know, the old soul singers that you could only find, like, on vinyl back in the day. I just was so drawn to that.
Were you, like, the only kid on your block who listened to that kind of
stuff? I was weird, yeah. That was different.
Let's go,
blues is derived from pain, and at a, you know, very young age, you know, kind of with my childhood growing up and whatnot, I just gravitated toward it. And I knew eventually I wanted to make a very, you know, soulful record, but maybe with a modern day twist, and I kind of wanted to incorporate the whole look and feel and vibe and sound, and that's where Back to Basics and this next, you know, chapter of my life is revolved.
Do you consider it a challenge to seeing if your younger fans will get the sort of throwback orientation of the record?
It's interesting. I had that realization kind of when I had my TRL visit for the first time in a while, and I was like, oh, what if they don't get it? You know, like, you don't think about that. What an amazing welcome back. Thank you. Just when I talk about it, I think they get how inspired I am and how passionate I am about what I'm doing. And, you know, I was a teenager when I first came out on the scene, huge pop explosion part of that whole thing. And I think I am a, you know, a hip-hop fan, and I am familiar with his music and a lot of the stuff he used to do with Biggie Smalls and Gangstar. And he did a lot of jazz elements. He chops things up. He goes for the obscure records and pieces and sounds. And we were able to keep those old elements, throw them with a modernized beat. I thought the melody kind of sounded almost as if you would take one of my old favorite soul singers and have them sing a melody of today in that kind of vein was what I wanted to accomplish. And it's fun.
Don't you feel like you've come a hell of a long way in just a few years?
Yeah, I mean, I feel from the place that I was at, to be able to, you know, be such a hands-on artist now, I'm just, you know, it feels amazing. I've done a lot of growing and a lot of healing since my last record, and I'm finally in a place that, you know, I feel pretty at peace. I'm happier than I've ever been, really. A lot of
you
good
feel
things.
Like, I mean, obviously finding oneself is probably an ongoing project.
Absolutely,
you know,
yeah, but, and I'm not done.
To oversexed video vixen. But through her ever-morphing image, Christina Aguilera undeniably laid claim to one title, one of the greatest vocal talents of her generation. Now, 4 years removed from her stripped era, the noticeably more mature, grounded, and newly married Christina has traded in the lascivious leather of ex-Stina for the vintage Hollywood glamour of Baby Jane, her new screen siren alter ego. With platinum curls and red, red lips, she's going back to basics, the name of her new double disc CD that pays homage to the classic jazz and blues she grew up listening to. In order to capture that throwback vibe, Aguilera called on veteran hip-hop producer DJ Premier and previous collaborator Linda Perry, who co-wrote this Christina classic.
You know, music has changed since that time that I came out. You know, it has grown up a bit, and I think the fans have grown up a bit, too. And I think they know by now that with each record that I kind of like to go to a new place.
Well, I think challenging as a choice for a first single is Ain't No Other Man, because as a high record as it is, it's not a conventional single. A song structure and those
right.
The horns.
But I'm also the kind of artist, I don't go to, when I go to make a record, I'm like, okay, who's hot now? Like, let me go to that producer or this hit maker of the moment. You know,
right.
I'm so not into that. I think that part of how I feel I need to express myself is always kind of going left field or thinking in a new direction and trying to challenge myself. The people that I chose to work with, especially, you know, Premier, DJ Premier has never, ever entered the quote-unquote pop scene or
right.
world.